Hello friends, I am Aditya Marathe from NewgenX, and what I will be doing in this video is showing you a quick demonstration of the mobile manipulator that I have with me. And after the demonstration, I will quickly explain the different parts of this mobile manipulator. So here we go. I am controlling it in a teleoperated fashion using a wireless joystick. So this is the joystick with which this increases its speed. So I can move it forward, backward. I can also move its direction in any way. Rotate it. So besides this, since it has this beautiful mechanical wheels with rollers, I can also move it sideways. So which can also be moved. So presuming we are holding something over here at the gripper, I can move this robot forward, move it back, move it to the right. I can also make it in brisk mode, in which this point will remain exactly where it is, and all the other joints of the or all the other actuators of this robotic arm will move around this point. So it will, the action will be like this, up, down, this way. So you can see this is moving up, keeping this point where it is. This is going down. This is again, you can move to the left. Or to the other direction. You can also rotate the gripper itself or open that close the gripper. So this was the basic working of the arm per se. Now, besides the mobile robot and the robotic arm, there are also a few very interesting sensors in this. So there is a camera and depth sensor right in front of it. There is also a LiDAR which gives a 2D map of the surrounding for this robot. Then inside the robot there is an IMU, which is an accelerometer to get the speed of the robot, a magnetometer to know the direction of the robot, and the third is a gyroscope to get the roll, pitch and yaw angles of the robot. So all this sensor data goes to the controller of the robot, which is right inside the inside this robot. This robot is presently working on the robot operating system, and we can program the whole mobile manipulator to move it autonomously by doing obstacle avoidance also. So you can write algorithms for it to do mobile manipulation such that it picks up from one point of the room, picks up an object and drops it at another place. So you can do a lot of algorithms and software using this mobile manipulator, which we'll be looking at in the subsequent videos. Thank you very much for looking at this video, and we will talk more about the technical aspects in much more detail in the coming videos. Thank you.